If the same lawsuit involves both legal and equitable claims, which one should be heard first? The United States Supreme Court provided an answer in Beacon Theaters versus Westover. Fox West Coast Theaters Incorporated operated a movie theater in San Bernardino, California. It had contracts with movie distributors that gave it the exclusive right to show first-run films in the area. Beacon built a drive-in theater 11 miles from San Bernardino. It notified Fox that it considered its contracts barring simultaneous showing of the same film in two theaters to be in violation of the Sherman Antitrust Act and the Clayton Act. These laws authorized suits for treble damages against violators. Fox filed a complaint for declaratory relief, seeking a declaration that its contracts with distributors didn't violate the antitrust laws and an injunction preventing Beacon from suing it under those laws. Fox claimed that Beacon's threats of suing for triple damages constituted duress and coercion that deprived Fox of its valuable property right, the right to negotiate for first-run contracts. Beacon filed a counterclaim, denying that it had threatened Fox and asserting that, because there was no substantial competition between it and Fox's theater, the restrictions on showing films simultaneously were unreasonable. It claimed that Fox and its distributors maintained a conspiracy to monopolize first-run movies in violation of antitrust laws. Beacon demanded a jury trial on the factual issues. The district court determined that Fox's complaint for declaratory relief, which included the question of competition between Beacon and Fox, was equitable. It directed that these issues be tried by the judge first before a jury trial could be held on the antitrust claims. The Court of Appeals upheld this ruling, finding that Fox's complaint was partly a plea for injunctive relief. The United States Supreme Court granted certiorari.
Thank you.